یہ ہجری کیلنڈر شروع ہونے سے پہلے عرب دیش میں میں مکہ مدینہ میں کون سا کیلنڈر رائج تھا, اور یہ عیسوی کیلنڈر اور اسلامی کیلنڈر میں مطلب کس طرح سے کنورشن کر سکتے ہیں ہم؟
Well, there was a question. He said, what was the calendar followed in Makkah and Medina before the Hijri calendar came? And how can you convert Hijri calendar to solar calendar? What are the difference? See, point number one, Hijri calendar wasn't existing before Hijri, but they followed the lunar calendar. There's two types of calendar, solar and the lunar. Solar is called the Gregorian calendar, and lunar in Islam it's Hijri. Lunar in Hinduism is a different Vedic calendar what they have. So the two types of calendar people follow throughout the world, lunar and the solar. In solar, what we follow normally in our office work, that's called Gregorian calendar. What we follow Muslims called Hijri calendar, because it starts from the Hijrat of Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. The Hijrat took place, that is the starting point. What we follow now, the Gregorian calendar is there, following the sun, but it's following on the Christ. But that is also not historically perfect, because Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, was born in 6 BC. 6 BC means BC before Christ. How can Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, be born on 6 BC? Doesn't make sense. It makes sense. Jesus Christ was born on 6 before Christ. Doesn't make sense. So that is how it is. But anyhow, it is mainly related to Jesus Christ, peace be upon him. Related, but the whole thing may have been jumbled up and they bent back, so now the whole calendar as whatever it is. Therefore, they see either Edward Christian error. They say anadonymy after death. After death is wrong because Muslims don't believe in after death. Before Christ, BC, no problem. Yes. But after death is wrong Islamically because we don't believe he died. So we say CE, Christian era, which is safe. Now coming back to what is the difference? The difference between the solar and the lunar calendar, or the Hijri and the Gregorian calendar, is that in the solar calendar, the same date comes in the same season. The solar calendar is based on the sun. 24 hours, one rotation of the earth is one day. And furthermore, one revolution of the sun around the earth is counted as 1 year. Now, when we follow the solar calendar, the climate depends upon the sun rather than the moon. So when we follow a solar calendar in that same country, in that same place, and that same date, in that same month, the same season will come. Like here, monsoon starts in June, then July, August, September is rain, then again winter starts, more in November, December, January, then summer starts. So monsoon, rainy season, winters will be on the same dates. Same in other parts of the country, autumn, spring, everything. It will keep on being same on the same date, same month. Now, because the climate is depending upon the sun, the revolution around the earth, in the lunar calendar, we depend upon the moon. So in the lunar calendar, in the same month, you don't have the same season. It keeps on changing. Compared to lunar and solar calendar, the lunar calendar is approximately 11 days less than the solar calendar. 11 days less than the solar calendar. So if you follow a lunar calendar, every 33 years, you have 1 year more than the solar calendar. So if I'm 33 years old, according to solar calendar, in lunar calendar, I'll be 34. Approximately 11 days multiplied by 33, I have 1 year approximately. But the advantage, we Muslims follow the lunar calendar. The advantage we have, that we have certain months, we have got certain things, like Ramzan, in the month of Ramzan, which is the 9th month. So now we realize, in Ramzan, for example, we have to fast. So if we have Ramadan out here, if it's winter in one part of the world, in the other part of the world, it will be summer. So those people living in that part of the world where summer is there, throughout their life, they'll be fasting in summer. You said, what kind of God has put me in this part of the world? Every time I'm fasting in summer. In the other part of the world, only in winter. So in 33 years, inshallah, we have a taste of summer, winter, spring, autumn, monsoon, every 11 years. And normally a lifespan is 33 years or 63 years, once or twice, we have a taste of everything. So it is more scientific and more logical. Therefore, since Ramadan is there, Hajj is there, all these come in particular season, so you have a taste of everything. So I feel it is more logical to follow the calendar. As far as following Islamic things are concerned, it is more scientific, better, and taste of everything. Hope that answers the question. Any brother have any questions? Yes, brother.
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam.
So what is the jihad actually, sir?